Hey there, so have you ever wanted to LARP as a resistance fighter, but find it too cumbersome? Like you don't have time climbing those basement steps, actually getting out into the sunlight? Your mom set a curfew, or she won't let you borrow the car, or maybe that 6XL t-shirt is just too hard to pull over your body? Well, I got something for you. This is the perfect way to always punch Nazis without actually leaving the comfort of your home. For the low, low donation price of $100 to get this going, ask your mom before using her credit card. You can go out and you can not only support something that allows you to punch Nazis, but if there's any money left over, it'll go to the Southern Poverty Law Center so you can label more people that you don't like, literally Hitler too. That's right, you got a pesky centrist living next door? That guy's a Nazi. Just ask those people. You have some firefighters trying to put out the fires right down the road from your favorite Starbucks? Well, don't worry about it. Those fires, they need to blaze. You know, according to the Southern Poverty Law Center, those people are probably just two steps away from being Nazis too. Policemen, don't worry about it. Antifa, they've told you all about it. You know exactly who those people are. Now here, with Always Punch a Nazi, you get 44 pages of comic book anthology about our country's battle against racism. Profits, they go from this Kickstarter again to the Southern Poverty Law Center. And well, at a $100 goal, I actually thought, well, is this a scam? You know, because $100 goal to get it started, that sounds a little scammy to me. But no, this is actually tied to another project. This person actually decided that they would go out and they would tie this to their business endeavors, because why not? I mean, if you have the courage of your conviction and you want to burn down any continued success, hey, have at it. Go out and not only punch those Nazis, but take away any goodwill while you're at it. That's a smart thing to do. This person actually had Saturn and Orion, Book 1. They not only did that, but they got out of their $2,500 goal, they got almost $800 more, and apparently they delivered on it. So, when you're backing this, it looks like it might actually be the real mill deal. But then again, you don't really know these days, because people like this, if they get enough money, and well, this might get enough money, or it might get shut down by those pesky Nazis, you know, Kickstarter, that might try to punch you back. That's right. You know, when I was looking at this, I thought, man, you know, those pesky alt-writers out there, they'll probably try to shut it down. I mean, you know, they'll bring up rules and they bring up regulations, you know, all of those things that socialism, of course, they don't have to adhere to, because why think about those pesky rules? After all, firefighters and policemen, they're Nazi. I'm sure that the people who wrote the rule books too, those people need to be carted off as well. But just to say what they'll probably use against you here, offensive material, hate speech, encouraging violence against others, etc. Oh man, those literally Hitlers out there, they're going to try to shut you down, I bet. And maybe they will. But anyhow, let's read about how great this is. Who wouldn't punch a Nazi? Everybody knows who the Nazis are. More so, if you saw a Nazi, you would want to punch that Nazi right across the face. Always Punch Nazis is the next best thing to actually punching a Nazi. And you can see the group of people you get together with. I mean, you see this guy with his focus in his rage here? You think that he's going to treat you like a pinata? You bet he is, Nazi. Yep, you see that swastika? It's crossed out in blood, Nazi blood. And this, don't even ask me what's up with this dominatrix and the little freak beside her, but yeah, I bet you this guy here with his American flag and walker, no, and that little punk, well, he's just going away from a day that was really, really good, or really bad, depending on his face there. Yep, look at the group of people you can get together with, because all these people, they want to punch a Nazi too. But continuing here, this 44-page anthology addresses the Nazi-like racism that has been plaguing America for many years. The creators of Always Punch Nazis address rising issues in America and how to handle hate handle bigots, rather, who want to oppress various citizens. No more, of course not. You're going to shut that down by suppressing it with this book. 44 pages of suppressing those Nazis. But continuing here, you will learn the most effective way to punch a Nazi, and yes, you definitely will. In fact, you'll get a little guideline that shows you how to. Literally Hitler that sucker right in his jaw. But continuing, a historical adventure about what happens when you continuously turn the other cheek. Basically, don't turn your cheek. Bloody the other person's nose and bruise theirs in the process. I think that's the message that we're getting here. How fighting for what's right can be passed down through many generations. Basically, you can pass this down, and if you say that you want to throw it in a birdcage because you want to turn it into liner, well, that's okay, because not only will you have great liner, but maybe your bird will learn how to punch a Nazi too. The same thing goes for gerbils. I wouldn't say it goes for snakes because they strike, but I don't know if striking and punching are the same thing. You know, strike a Nazi? Maybe that'll be our next 44-page anthology. Who knows? But continuing here, and many more fun adventures about standing up for what's right. Help us. Help the good people at the Southern Poverty Law Center fight for those who need help fighting for themselves. Yep, put together all of these, add a little bit of lens flare too. We can J.J. Abrams this kind of stuff up because that's what we need in our fight against Nazis. Who is this guy anyway, leading this fight, you might ask? Well, thankfully there's a section there too, and he tells you how he's motivated and all. After the horrific events in Charlottesville, North Carolina, this person, the CCO of Pilot Studios, approached his team with a challenge. He and Silas Dixon wanted to do something to help battle the growing racial divide in the U.S. This mission led to the birth of Always Punch Nazis. Who wouldn't want to punch a Nazi? Quickly became the motto of the book you're purchasing. Who wouldn't want to punch a Nazi? I mean, just get out the phone book. You see a guy that has a kind of Aryan name? Well, that's a Nazi. Let's go out and let's punch him. Let's see if that works out for you. Yep, you know, sounds like a good thing. We like to punch more chins than a Chinese phone book. That's what our other guy said, but we had to get rid of him because he was a Nazi. But continuing here, Ben also asked for the creators to volunteer their talent in order to send all profits to a worthwhile cause. So where do those funds go? They don't go in Ben's pocket, that's for sure. Wink, wink. Nope. They go to the creators of Always Punching Nazis, donating their time and talent to create the book you're purchasing. So all the funds, they'll go to Kickstarter, printing costs, shipping supplies, postal fees, and then Southern Poverty Law Center. Those Nazis taken away, it should just go to the Southern Poverty Law Center. In fact, let's just skip the middleman and send them the book. Send them the book rights, too. That would be the way to go. But here's a sample page here. I punched a lot of Nazis in my time. Granted, most of it was in World War II. I like the most there. Wink, wink. Punched my way all across Germany before I got to the big man. Before I was done. But let's be honest, you can never really be done punching Nazis. Wink, wink. Trail of punches. Oh, isn't that lovely? Then it, of course, tells you about the Southern Poverty Law Center and what they do. It gives you a little bit of click there. Because, of course, you know, like I said, if you like LARPing resistance, why would you actually want to go out and do your own due diligence? I mean, when you're LARPing that fight, you know, the fight to resist, it's easy to put a hashtag on it, splice it up, and it's easier to click a button within this, so yeah, you got it confirmed. But not only that, if you actually do run into a Nazi, this book, it'll show you how to punch one. How to punch a Nazi. Nazis should be punched, says this guy here. Like how he rolled that sleeve up, like how he's bulging out there, because just like the Hulk, he's got on a few pesky pounds. Only instead of gamma radiation, we're probably talking about a few too many trips to McDonald's here that changed this guy into a beast. But yeah, as a rational human being, you understand that Nazis should be punched. But do you know how to correctly throw a punch? I don't know. Do you know how to directly throw a punch? Well, here you go. Follow these easy steps to make the world a better and less hateful place. So you literally get to punch people to make the world a less hateful place. Yeah, I like that. That's a great way, Standard. Don't like somebody? Think they're a monster? Go ahead and punch them, because that's going to make the world safer. You know, that argument, that's why I like buying guns. Because, you know, the more guns that I pick up, well, the safer the world becomes. Oh, wait, that's not one of our mottos here. No, we don't like guns. Never mind, we just like punching people. But continuing, number one, find a Nazi. Any Nazi. Oh, that guy, you'll do. Now make a fist. You extend all four fingers. Now practice this at home before you find a Nazi, because the Nazis don't usually just stand there like cardboard cutouts. Also, if you find a guy who's a neo-Nazi, he's probably going to kick the piss out of you, because, you know, unless you're a big guy, he's not going to look like this dude. But anyhow, curling those fingers up, you know, want to curl them inward there. Make sure your thumb lays across the top of your index and middle finger, because you don't want to break it. Then attack. You want to square up, looking like a fool, because apparently your pants legs are going to roll up on you. Forcefully rotate your hips and torso as you extend your right arm. Connect. Smush. The guy goes, Mr. Potato Head, and you've won, of course. Give him or her, equal opportunity thrashing. Gotta love that. The Fist of Reason. Admire your work. Oh, isn't that lovely there? Now keep punching. Never stop. Who the who's who of Nazis? Nazis, it used to go without saying that they were scum. They were the bad guys, and everyone knew without hesitation. We knew there were Nazi sympathizers out there, but they were hidden. They would never dare show their faces in public. It's 2018 in the USA, and the far right, sometimes called the alt-right, sometimes called white nationalists, sometimes called Nazis, sometimes called centrists. I got you back here. I'm going to fix it. Sometimes called rationalists, sometimes called old-school liberals, sometimes called the guy next door, sometimes called the guy who delivers your paper, sometimes the guy who drives down the road at like 2 a.m. blaring music you don't like. Anyway, I mean, are back in the national conversation. They think they're vile, racist, anti-immigrant, anti-black, anti-Asian, anti-gay, anti-Jew, anti-anything but white, Christian view, deserve a place at the table. That's hard to say. They think we need to listen to their viewpoints as if they are reasonable opinions, espoused by reasonable people. Screw that, man. That's right. All those people on the right side of the page know what you do when a Nazi starts babbling about white homeland. They all know what to do when a fool wants to tell you Donald Trump is trying to make America great again. Because we all know he really means he wants to make America white again. Wow, that is astounding. Always punch Nazis. And then they talk about the prophets. That right there, that makes it clear as day who exactly you're going to go out and punch. Yep, going to punch those Donald Trump supporters, those pesky 63 million voters, those Nazis, I swear. Then, of course, you can see what you can get. $5 PDF, $15, you get a printed edition, $25 for a head sketch, multiple copies. Ooh, you could get you a head sketch. Man, what about this page here? What do you got to give to get that? Can I trade in 3 sacks of used ramen and maybe the career of Aubrey Sitterson? Wink, wink, you know what I mean, because he doesn't have one. But anyhow, I'm going to end on that because, well, I might get punching the wrong people, and you wouldn't want that. Nope, you want to punch the Nazis, and you know who they are. Well, we told you, but if you really want to know, you'll want to pick this up. So what do you think about this project? I mean, looking through this, my God, you look at that and you think this will probably get canceled, but maybe it won't, because this is Kickstarter. Kickstarter only pulls out the hate speech it doesn't like, aka things that really have to do with comic books, but this, it'll probably pass. But anyhow, what do you think about that? Thank you.